What's good YouTube, Dilfertas here, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be taking a look at the X squat and the reverse X squat. Two exercises done in the same machine, but that are a little bit different. So sit back, relax, and enjoy, because without any further ado, we're going to jump straight into the video. So first of all, what's the big difference between doing a squat with a barbell, for example, and X squat? The big difference here is basically the balance. All those stabilization movements that you need to do while doing with conventional squat with a barbell are basically eliminated, because you are doing the movement on a machine. Your stance is fixed and your movement is as well fixed. You don't have to worry about balancing the barbell for not falling forward or backward. So in theory, doing an X squat is easier than doing a barbell squat. Back into the video, the difference between an X squat and a reverse X squat. Basically, in the X squat, you'll be putting much more emphasis on your quads. But since the movement is fixed, your hips will not be traveling backwards while you're going down and flexing your knees. And this will result in much more stress on your knees rather than in your lower back, like in a traditional squat with a barbell. You'll be taking out the stress of your lower back while going down and supporting the weight and putting it on your knees. Basically, you'll be getting much more quad activation, but you'll be putting much more stress on your knees. So it is something that you need to take in consideration if you want to do the X squat. What about the reverse X squat? You have probably seen somebody do this exercise already. It is basically an exercise done in the X squat machine, but facing the machine. Instead of simply having the machine on your back, you'll be facing the machine and applying all the weight on your front delts. And what are the benefits of doing the reverse X squat? Basically, in the reverse X squat, your hips will be able to go backwards as in the traditional barbell squats, but by doing this, we'll be shifting the emphasis from your quads for your hamstrings, your glutes, and your lower back. Basically, doing a reverse X squat will look and feel much more like a traditional barbell squat, but still done in the machine. You will not have to worry about stabilization as much as in a barbell squat, but you'll be putting more stress on your lower back than if you are doing the traditional hack squat. So basically, all you need to take in consideration if you want to do the hack squat or the reverse hack squat is the muscles that you want to target. If you want to target more of your quads, you can focus on doing the traditional hack squat. And if you want to focus on eating more your hamstrings, your glutes, and your lower back, you can focus on doing the reverse hack squat. As I've told you, both of them have advantages and disadvantages. Being the advantage of the X squat, putting a lot of more emphasis on your quads, but the disadvantage, putting a lot of stress on your knees. And in the other way around, if you do the reverse X squat, you're putting more emphasis on your hamstrings, your glutes, and your lower back, taking off the tension from your knees, but putting more tension on your lower back. It is up to you what you want to focus and work more by doing one or the other. Me personally, I don't like to do the normal X squat. I prefer to do a barbell squat. For me, it is the best exercise to build my legs, the conventional barbell squat. But if I need to do X squat exercise, I'd rather do the reverse X squat rather than the conventional X squat. First of all, I will not be putting as much stress on my knees. And second of all, I feel my legs working more overall by doing the reverse X squat, and not as much if I try to do the normal X squat. Of course, I'll feel my quads, but I don't feel that putting a little bit more emphasis on the quads will be beneficial enough for the risk that you are putting on your knees. So it is basically up to you if you want to work more of your quads or your hamstrings, your glutes, and your lower back. If you want more quads, do the normal X squat. If you want more hamstrings, glutes, and lower back, do the reverse X-Squad. So that's basically it for today. I hope you all enjoyed this video and enjoy all of this information. If you haven't tried already, try both the X-Squad and the Reverse X-Squad and see if you can benefit from it. If you like the video, don't forget to drop me a like, also to consider subscribing so you don't miss my next video coming next week. Also, comment down below what I should do next. As always, thank you so much for watching and I hope to see you in the next one.